Today we're going to be doing a 6x2 full snatch. 6x2 being 6 sets of 2 reps. And we're going to approach it by minimum weight, working technique, and not missing. That's the most important thing. So when you come over the bar, I want you to get in a plie kind of position, okay? Really push your knees out as much as possible. Some people call it the frog position, right? So when I'm coming up, my knees are automatically out of the way of the barbell. You're mimicking opening the hips. So when you do a box jump, how do you finish?
Right.
On your toes, right? Yeah. Same exact thing. When you get on your toes, open the hips, you finish your pull. When you're lifting at max weight, you jump as high as you can. So when you look at like professional weightlifters, you don't see them get off the ground. They're like this. But the whole goal is to get off the ground. The reason why they're not getting off is because they got 400 pounds on the barbell, right?
Right.
So higher the jump, the more explosive you are, the more weight you put up. Set in position. So the barbell should be right in the crease of your hip, right where the pubic bone is right there.
Oh, okay.
Feel that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now go ahead and like try and make some contact with that. Bring your hips out, come right back into the bar. Yeah, just like that. Beautiful, cool. Come into the bar with your hips. Make it rattle. Yeah! That was a great contact right there. I think you got surprised, actually.
Yeah, I did.
Dude, that was awesome. Yeah. Dude, that's the contact you got to make right there.
Okay.
Exactly. So when you're doing the snatch, I don't want you to kamikaze into that bottom position, right? Because it's going to put you out of position. So I want you to think muscle snatch, finishing your pull, and then entering the squat as if you're going into quicksand.
Yeah.
I'm not disappointed that I'm doing less than usual because I know this is going to help me out.
Get deep. There you go. Uh-huh. Oh, there you go. Yeah, there you go. So staying down there, finding that positioning, it's going to be better when you go into your full snatch. You're going to find that pocket and stick it. We like to go slow from the floor to hold positioning.
Right.
Now, when you hold that positioning, it's easier to, you know, go into your second pull and proceed in that bottom position. But if you also rush the bottom position, you could lose control and positioning of that barbell. So it's about consistency and control.
185, 205, 225, and then you started backing down, back to 185 for the last 3 sets.
Yeah.
How come? Tell me why you did that.
Well, today I didn't really have enough confidence in my grip, because if I wanted to go more, I would have definitely used straps just to hold onto the bar, but the bar's starting to slip out of my hands, so I felt I could go down and just work technique as well at 85% of my, you know, 2-set rep today.
Right.
And actually, I don't recommend straps for CrossFitters usually, because when you're, you know, doing WODs, what are you doing? You're either dropping the bar, throwing at it, gripping and ripping,
moving, rep.
Exactly. Yeah. And so there's really no reason for straps.
Right.
So if you're going, you know, maximum lifts as an Olympic weightlifter, it definitely helps.
Right.
But as a CrossFitter, there's really no need for straps.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah. Here we go, man.
Squeeze. Tight. Whoa. There he goes. Nice.
Got some obstacles.
Yeah.
Got some obstacles.
There you go.
Thanks for having me out.
Yeah, for sure.
Good job, man.
Thanks for all your help, man.
No problem.
It's really, like, it's going to help me out a lot.